हाम्रा ग्रामीण जनताले भोग्नु परेको दुःख र कठिनाई निवारणका निमित्त युवराज चार्ल्सको संरक्षण प्राप्त संस्थाहरूद्वारा देशका कतिपय जिल्लाहरूमा लोकोपकारी कार्यहरू सम्पन्न भइरहेका छन्।
Deep in his mind, he always wanted to create something parallel to the Prince's Trust. That was his aspiration. I saw in him a very disillusioned, frustrated young man who wanted to do a lot, but was pretty much stopped from doing a lot that he could do because of the circumstances. He would not have vented his frustration against his parents in public. It's not just a father and son relationship, it's the king and the crown prince. This is a completely different plane altogether.
Like many of the king's subjects, the crown prince had been brought up to revere his father as a living incarnation of Lord Vishnu. But as with his mother, a rift was beginning to tear Dipendra and his father apart. The reason was political. By the year 2000, Nepal was sliding into chaos as Maoist guerrillas gained footholds in many of the poorer parts of the kingdom. In his coronation speech, the king had spoken of his desire to see the hungry fed, the naked clothed, and the sick tended. But after 25 years of promises, his subjects were looking elsewhere for salvation. Putting his faith in parliamentary democracy, the king refused to send in the army to crush the rebels. But his son Dipendra began to believe the only solution to his country's problems was force. Fearing revolution, he began to stockpile weapons in his bedroom. Ten years after Dipendra first met Devyani, he had reached a stalemate with his family, his country, and his lover. Worst of all, his parents now faced him with an impossible choice: his royal position or marriage to Devyani Rana. He could not have both.
Clearly, he was bent on marrying Devyani, but if he were to be told, you can do that, but then you lose your royal privileges, for a man like Dipendra, that would be losing a lot, because what he had to show to the world more than anything else was his royal status.
The crown prince was further humiliated when his younger sister, the king's favorite, Princess Shruti, produced the first royal grandchild. Under pressure, the crown prince began to flaunt his love affair in Kathmandu's fashionable restaurants. He started to drink more heavily and to smoke marijuana.
I mean, how would one control a 20 to 30 year old guy, you know, who is educated? How do you try to do anything to such a person? And on top of that, he's also the crown prince, so that even, I guess, makes it difficult for you to go and say, you know, you shouldn't be doing this. It's a delicate, difficult, and a very awkward situation.
Dipendra's sister, Princess Shruti, did try to break through royal protocol and talk to her brother on his 29th birthday.
Nobody hates anybody. Nobody. I mean, I've never heard of anybody hitting anybody. Her case was the first case when she came and said, look, my brother hit me and she had a bruise here. And I was like, my God, I mean, I didn't know what to say because, you know, firstly he's a crown prince. Then, you know, and I just said, that's not done. You know, it's just hitting, you could be anybody, you don't hit a woman.
Princess Shruti had left her brother's party with bruises on her face. Dipendra had shocked the young royals by announcing he would marry Devyani. If prevented, the family would bear the consequences.
What he said was, well, it's been difficult for me to reach a decision. I mean, I've toyed with the idea for 6 or 7 years as to who I should get married to, and I've made up my choice. And my wife reacted, saying, oof, that, which basically means, what are you saying? Then he just literally ran across and he just caught her by her throat and pushed her to the ground and was right about to kick her. And she was about 5 months pregnant then. And I really could not do anything because that would be considered inappropriate for me to do because he's the crown prince. But he was literally shouting, you know, you're either with me or you're not with me. And anyone who gets in my way, I'll finish them, literally kill them, whether it be my father, mother, finish the monarchy and bring down the institution with me.
The threat was so sinister that those present found it unbelievable. One year later, what seemed like the hollow words of a drunk had become a terrible reality.
I saw the king just put up his hand and the look he gave his son. And I could see he was saying, I can contain the damage, but if you take a step further, I can't help you. I've never seen such a stern look from King Birendra. And yet he shot him through the head.
Dipendra now turned towards his sister.
I heard a shot and I actually felt her strength, you know, give way. Like, I mean, I felt some, like she was holding me, and that strength slowly, sort of, you know, gradually faded away, and she fell down.
Then he just shot everybody, and he aimed and he shot at their heads.
He was out there spraying bullets, I mean, like a madman.
He shot my shoulder off, but the blood all came all over my face and my head. So he must have thought he got me in the head also. I watched him kill Princess Sharda. She tried to put her body between him and her husband. And I just saw the back of her head go flying off.
And he just went around kicking some bodies and just shooting them from close range at their heads. And just to ensure that, I mean, they had died. And I just remember the light going across my eyes. And I was thinking to myself, oh God, he's going to shoot me in my head and I'm going to die now. The bullet hit my thumb and entered my body, so my thumb took a lot of impact. But by losing a thumb, I guess, you know, it saved my life.